Hello and welcome back. We are going to very quickly go over the Empty Arms solo, or not solo, intro. But there will be a few more videos after this, Empty Arms related. We're just going to kind of go through the whole song as a series. So let's just go through the intro. I'll play the part I'm going to teach you and then we'll get into it. Great song, and I will say, I am in a standard tuning, but I'm going to play in the original key here in the B minor pentatonic area. But yeah, so just to start it off, we're just going to kind of go through this quickly. The G string on the 7th fret, pluck that hammer on to 8, and then bar the B and the E here on the 7th fret, and then I hybrid pick that high E there. And then 10th fret on the B with our ring finger. 7th fret of the E, back to the 10th fret of the B with a little bend. And then we do this little D minor shape chord. And try to rake up into that first note if you can. So you do that twice. On the third time, so that bend there on the B, not quite a whole step, but then you're gonna catch the high B and E here on the 7th fret. And in the recording, there's a little bit of a slop in here, so I feel like he's going for this every time, but sometimes you're getting less of the B string, or maybe the B string's choking a little bit and you just get the E, but that's totally fine. That adds to the charm. So after you do that four times, yeah, notice how I pre-bend here on the G, on the 9th fret. Pull off to 7, hammer onto the D string 9th fret, back to the 7th on the G, and we're going to bend it. But you hit it twice in that one bend. And then we're going to go to the D string 9, pull off to 7, A string 9th fret, back to the D string, walk it up. And on the 7th fret of the A. And then we're kind of in a position here to get our ring finger ready. Sorry about my dog. Ring finger ready. And this is where kind of like some Pride and Joy-esque swingy rhythm things come in. But we're going to slide on the top three strings here. Up a step to the 9th fret. And then we're going to be going back and forth. Here. That last one, just hammer on that 8th fret of the G. And I'm not going to go super into like meticulously on like rhythms and stuff like that, so just really get the notes down, get your left hand super confident, and then if you need help with the rhythm stuff, you know, that's what is the great thing about YouTube, is you can slow down the video and play along with me and stuff. So I'll try to like take it slow, but I'm not going to stick around on anything for too long. The second chord is just the D string and the B string here on the 7th fret. And I like to rest my index finger here on the G to mute it. Same kind of thing. And on the A string, we're going to do a slide from 2 to 9. And we're going to hit it on both ends. And you don't start the slide immediately. You don't go, you know, there's a. And then that sets us up to do the same thing we did, you know, with the. But just a step up. And we're not sticking around there for very long, because right after this, we're going to do a. And the reason I don't just use my index finger, it doesn't feel very comfortable. Maybe it's just the neck on the silver sky or something. But I tend to start it with the ring finger and with the middle finger, because that, anyway, sets us up to do another slide here. And that's the first, that's the last thing you play before the intro solo. Which starts on the D string, 9th fret, give a couple hits. G string, 7th fret, hammer on to 8. Back to 7, give it a couple hits. And hammer on that second one. And then that note on the 9th fret of the D, give it a little bit of vibrato. And slide it down. And you come back up, and you're filling the gaps with, you know, rhythm section. And you slide down, because we're going to slide back up. And I slide with my middle finger up to the 8th fret here, and as soon as I get to that 8th fret, I hybrid pick that B and E. So it's really fast here. And that's 10th fret of the B. We're going to do, like, almost a whole step bend. And then I pluck that with my finger. You know, And that's just G string, 9th fret. Back down, 7th fret. To fill the space. And then we're going to slide back up again. And after the bend this time, this is new. We're kind of going from, you know, B bend from E to B. And I'm hybrid picking that as well. This is a really good song to practice hybrid picking. And then we go to this note, 10th fret of the E. And you should expect to kind of bend it up a little bit so you have more room on the board to give it a nice wide vibrato, and it'll sound really nice. And then this is where that kind of hybrid picking motion that I was doing earlier comes in. So just a very quick hybrid picked. That's just a nice pre-bend there on the G. And when you pull off, you're continuing the bend to pull down. You know, you're continuing after the reset of the bend. To kind of make that pitch go back up there on the 7th fret just a little bit. Little micro bend. And then two hits there, 9th fret of the D. And then another little micro bend there on the G. And then we come back up, we choke that out, and then we get ready to bend back up on that 9th fret. Back to this B and E thing. Another bend on the 10th fret of the B. Back to that 7th fret of the G, or E. Another one of these G string up and down. Two hits on the D string. This is very familiar territory. Except this time we're going to go to the 9th fret of the B. Back to the 7th. 10th fret, little micro bend. And those notes, 10th fret of the high E, 7th fret, 9th fret of the B, 7th fret of the B. And then we go to the 10th fret of the B on that second time, I think. Yeah. Actually, no. I misspoke. Yeah, so you just basically go back and forth on the B and E string here. Tenth fret of the B. a couple bends here, catching the note you're bending into on the B. And you can get that E string in there too. Bring it back down. Little micro bend there on the 7th fret. Octave on the thumb. You know, that's a pretty fun little selective muting practice thing to do. But yeah. I hope I didn't rush too much through anything. Just honestly, like, DM me on Instagram with like a timestamp and just be like, oh, what is this? I was kind of confused on this part, and I can clear things up. But yeah, this is a little weird not being able to see my face, but yeah, this is a quick little thing. Hope it was useful. Let me know. Give me feedback. Love you guys. Bye.